Hi, happy Wednesday. We're so happy to see you. My name is Gigi. I'm with 3D Theatricals. And on behalf of my entire team here, I'd like to welcome you to this session of 3D+U. You are in such a treat. And if you've had this session before, you know that already. But to be able to interpret all these feelings through movement and through a song, you just, you know, for a lay person who just sees your performance, just taking it for granted how it just comes so naturally, the work that goes into it, it's quite awe-inspiring. So I will give you to your awe-inspiring instructor today, Natalie. Natalie, it's all yours.
Hi, good morning. We're going to do a little storytelling today. And I think the best way to encourage a sense of storytelling, especially through movement, is to understand that sometimes we get caught up in dance. And what dance is in terms of like the technique and the structure and the codified little box that it's in. But within my dance training, I've really discovered that it is at the basis of all humanity, right? This like deep sense of understanding movement. So that's what we're going to explore today. And we're going to get creative. So this is definitely going to be a class that's very stress-free and very much just about your own personal experience. So you can take it however you want. You can leave your video on or off, whatever makes you feel comfortable and open today. And maybe if you feel up to it at the end of class, we can all put our videos on so we can share kind of the work that we've created. We're going to start class with a Gaga-inspired warm-up, and Gaga not as in Lady Gaga, though I love her. We're going to do more of a Gaga inspired by a choreographer named Ocha Naharim from Israel. He is the artistic director of the Bat Sheva Dance Company, and the style is really big on sensing movement from a sensation-based place. So we're going to create emotion that's already in our body. It's one of my favorite things to do. So we're going to kind of do an inspired warm-up like that. So just lean into being uncomfortable, because it really is the opportunity. When you get uncomfortable, that's when you're going to discover something really incredible. So we'll start really easy here. We're going to back up into our space, whatever space works for you. And I don't know why I have this beautiful, like, goddess light shining from somewhere. We can't figure it out. So just enjoy my own lighting here. I got fairy lights and all kinds of stuff in here. And we're gonna start by just sort of sensing where your body's at. So shifting from side to side, allowing yourself to feel your feet in the floor. Just moving your weight side to side. Sensing how the floor reacts. Maybe there's a maybe it's almost carpet, so it, you can feel how the plush goes up and down. Just sensing how your knees are. Are they feeling kind of stiff this morning, stuck? If so, that's just fine. Allow them to get a little softer. Soft being the feet, soft being the sense of soft. Keep that shifting going. Our goal in this class is to always keep moving, even if that means that we're just sort of swaying. We're going to slowly allow the body to just invite a sense of movement. If you spend a lot of your time still or sitting, this might feel a little bit uncomfortable or exhausting in maybe some ways. That's okay. We're going to lean into that idea of just getting a little tired. And we'll explore why later. So keep this shifting going. And then imagine that the shifting starts to create a little bit of a river or an ocean underneath you. So your arms sort of float on top of the waves. And then you can start to pick up your feet. Maybe rolling the ankles and just allowing the ocean to sort of hold you. As we go deeper into this practice for this warm up, the number one thing is to keep your eyes open. You're going to want to close them because you're going to want to experience internally. know we can't do that on stage. So how do we stay available, open, and internal for emotions to come up and also be aware of the space? So with that in mind, really open up your eyes and start to look around the space. Observe the corners. Observe the edges. Keep the body moving. Most important, right? Just floating in water. See the ceiling. Is it stucco or wood? Is it painted? Are there spider webs in the corners? Observe this space that you've been in. Let's use the word lovingly confined, kept safe, right? Find something new about it. Really using your eyes. Good. Nice. Keep it going. Good. Good. And then let's start to imagine some circles in the body. So imagine a little, maybe a little rat or a little mouse. Let's say mouse. They're sometimes cuter for unknown reasons. And it's going to sort of run up your body in circles. So there's almost a sense of joy about it. If you don't like rats or mice, maybe you can do a cute little otter or a kitty cat running all the way up and around your body. So can you actually see where the cat starts? Maybe. And then where it finishes, where it runs off. Good, so you're making these nice circles in the body. And remember, you can always copy me if you feel like you're at a loss of what to do. You can always just copy me, and then I think you'll discover that there's so much emotion and movement in your own body, you don't need to follow along or copy. Good, so let these circles start to take over. Is there places you're forgetting? What about your head? That's a one for me. I always forget. You create circles in your head, in your shoulder blades, in your waist, in your hips. Good. And if you're starting to feel like, do I look like an absolute insane person? I want you to lean into that with a big inhale and a nice big exhale. To not be crazy is to live a boring life. So let's get goofy. Let's get crazy. Let's get enjoy fully what life has to offer. Good, and we're moving. And I want you to feel like maybe you're overwhelmed by these circles. So instead of enjoying them, you feel overwhelmed. Can you tap into that emotion? Can you create your own experience of feeling whelmed? Gosh, whew. And if you're getting tired, I want you to lean into that exhaustion. That's good. Let your body get tired. Let it feel like it needs to release something. Good. And we're going to get a little bit faster. Let these circles overwhelm you. What about your knees, your ankles, your feet, your fingers? Good. And if you feel up to it and no one's asleep in your house at 11, we're going to count down from 10. 10, getting faster. 9, 8, push yourself. 7, push yourself. 6, push yourself. 5, 4, fastest. 3, faster. 2, faster. 1, don't drop the energy, float. But stay high above it. Ooh, there's that nice heart rate. Can you enjoy it? Feel alive. Feel sensation. Shake to our pelvis. It can feel goofy. That's okay. Yeah, just let it feel goofy. Whew. And can it be really nice and isolated in the pelvis? So the chest isn't reacting yet. Maybe a little bit, right, naturally. But for the most part, we're isolating the shake down into our hips. Good. Ah, just a little dance. Shake, shake, shake. Whew. Shake, shake, shake. Good. Get silly. Let yourself enjoy, right? So here's the shake, right? You're making it happen. And because we're human beings, there's a natural available. availability of emotion here, which is joy or silliness. When you're at the club with your friends, you can picture that. You're dancing, the music's loud. You can let your body just react how it wants to react. You're gonna let it shake. And then can you allow that shake to come up a little bit more into your chest? So there's a reverb. So your chest starts to get part of the party. Now maybe you're like, if you're of age, maybe you're a few shots in, you're kind of like, oh, yeah, get it going. Maybe this is that party scene, right? In the show that you're doing, in the theatrical. You really want to just be human. How can you let the emotion, the movement, cause your performance versus putting the performance on top of the movement? It's all coming from inside. It feels silly. So this is a shake, and your legs can start to shake and your wrists. Good, and maybe we shake at a level where we could do it for 4 days. Could you do this for 4 days? I think so. Just shaking straight for 4 days. Find a level that works for you, that you could maintain for 4 days. All right, and then maybe a level that you could maintain for a day. Maybe it's a little bit bigger, right? A little bit more joyful. It's a little bit more of a party. And then maybe only a shake that you could control for a minute. Really let yourself shake. No one is watching you. If your camera is off, maybe your mom or your significant other thinks you're crazy because they're looking at you from the kitchen, but you don't care. You just let it go. Shake it out. Let it go. Shake your mama gave you. Let it out. Shake it out. Giggle. Feel tickled. Feel tickled by the experience of shaking. Maybe someone is tickling you. Have that image. The shake isn't coming from you, but it's being given to you. You feel tickled around your waist, around the back of your knees, around your feet, in your chest. Count down with me for 10, 9, 8, can you get bigger? 7, really let the shake come from the hips. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lift your arms up. Feel the flow. You'll want to collapse, fight it. Breathe into the feeling of being alive. Stretch your arms up really long. Let your feet come to a nice easy parallel. Stretch your arms up. Can you feel your waist lengthening? Breathe. Can you reach any higher? You can allow your knees to bend. I want you to think big yawning stretches. Stretching body parts away from one another. Reaching. Good. Then bring the arms back up nice and high. And then I want you to just be controlled by gravity. So let the arms drop. And then bring them back up. And then again, controlled by gravity. Good, and bring them back up. Now you pull the arms down. Good. Reach them back up. Good. And pull them down again. You see the difference, right? So when we go up and we let gravity take us, it's a different energy, a different emotion. But when we pull our own arms down, there's a different thing, right? Let's do it in the reverse. Let gravity take your arms up. It's harder, right? And let them drop back down. And again, let gravity take them up. Good, and let them go back down. Good, and now pick your arms up. Beautiful. Yes, even these little boxes, I can see it. Good, again, lift your arms up. Nice, good, and then go into an easy float. And notice now, are you shaped by gravity? Or can you shape yourself around gravity? Can you feel it? And then in this experience, are you just body. Check in. If you think this is silly, why? Just check in. How can you let yourself have the full expression and experience? Don't keep yourself fearful or nervous. Don't watching your hands, your body. Good, and let's go with our hands. You're painting. Are you sort of a goddess? Are you making a brew? Or are you an alien? Kind of creeping. Okay? Are you sort of creating something eerie? Or maybe you're creating something beautiful. Maybe you are drawing a forest. You're like a godly figure and you're creating oceans and rivers and trees. Good. Notice how those three things change. Let's play with those three ideas. Let's go to the witch's brew. How does the texture of your hands change, right? How are you seeing the hands? It's going to change you energetically in your mind. Really seeing what you're brewing.
Having a bath.
Good. Then maybe you're the alien. That's going to be maybe creepy, maybe sinister alien, maybe sad alien, maybe ET. You're not sure how to use your fingers. And if you're feeling goofy, laugh, whatever, who cares, right? Allow yourself to feel joy. Whatever comes up, let it out. And then lastly, the beautiful one, letting you create existence. Good, and let's go with that because it feels yummy. Can that start moving into your body in a whole? Can you start really seeing the space that you've created? All the drawings, all the beauty, all of it. And then start to hit your skin. Everywhere on your skin, your arms, your legs, your back, your booty. Pick up that flesh and joy. Just start to slap wherever. Doesn't have to be hard. All the way, even in your armpits, maybe you realize you forgot to put deodorant on today. Usually happens to me. Slapping all over. Get faster. Maybe your face, if you're comfortable touching your face, maybe the back of your head, the back of your neck, your chest, the inner thighs maybe. Everywhere on your body that you can think of to wake up. And count down with me if you feel like it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let yourself float. This is my favorite, where I can just feel the skin alive, tingling. Everywhere in my body, places that were asleep before, suddenly feel awake, available. And last thing here, we're gonna get into a cold shower. So, might have a little quake to it. Maybe you're just enjoying the water. Maybe you really needed the cold shower. Feel free to make noises, right? We're trying to understand how movement can drive our acting, can drive our dancing from a human experience. So, in this cold shower, maybe you just ate an Oreo, so you can still taste the Oreo in your mouth. Or a sweet piece of fruit. You can taste it on your lips. And at the same time, you're taking this cold shower. You're enjoying all of these experiences. Good. And then the shower gets a little colder, a little bit more uncomfortable. Remember, keep your eyes open. Ooh, it's cold. Okay. And can you feel that cold actually on your body? Don't put the cold on, but feel the cold from inside. It's going to change the emotion. It's going to change what comes up. If you're getting emotional, that's good. I am. Let it out. Let it out. It's trapped. It wants to be shared. Really cold shower. Ice cold. Pins and needles. You're just getting smaller in your body because it's so cold. Last thing, count down from 10.
Just say the word now. 9. Throw a lasso around. 8. And pull it down.
7. Ooh, 6. 5. 4.
Give you the move.
3. 2. It's the coldest it's ever been. 1. And let it flow. So take a second for yourself to just explore all of those concepts. Trust yourself. There's not a wrong here. Can you feel the circles again? The bends, the folds in your body, the neck. Just let yourself feel to this beautiful song, connecting to movement. And now you're a dancer. This is really the whole equation. If you're expressing yourself as a human being, from movement, that's a dancer. So breathe, express, enjoy. If you have more, maybe in the box technique, feel free to explore it. Feel free to explore legs and weight shifts a little bit more. Allow the music to just take you on a little bit of a roller coaster. Letting your spine feel like seaweed. Place your hand on your chest. Feel soft right here at your heart. Oneness with the body.
I'll take it.
Beads of sweat dripping down the back.
And you can swallow it, and it all dissolves.
Everything might seem more heightened now. You might be able to hear different sounds.
Your fingers and your toes and the ends of your hair.
Feel different emotions. Stay soft in your chest. Let your jaw go. Take a deep breath in. And an exhale. Just enjoy a moment of stillness, of silence, of breath. Good, one more deep breath in. And let it go. Good, release from that. See how you feel. Good, I only have 2 people with their videos on, but how do you feel? Good, thumbs up. Yeah. And if you don't, if you want to write in the chat how you're feeling about it, how that experience was for you, I'd always love to hear just what you experienced in that. If you want to share, sometimes I think sharing allows us to feel even more comfortable in our own experience. So if anyone wants to share in the chat near the end of class or share right now, please feel free to put your video on and I'll catch you and then we can sort of talk about it. If not, no pressure. Maybe you're feeling super private today. Good. Run with that. That's all good. So what we're gonna do, here we go, good. Ooh, yeah, uh-huh, mm-hmm. Yes, 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 good. I think I've never taken an acting class, but I know that a lot of this derives or has similarities to conceptions of acting classes and how to let that go, right? Because I think we get so trapped in the concept of, especially in theater, we tend to like build on top of versus build from within. So this is a good opportunity and an exciting thing to build from within. Oh yeah, the hands, good. Yeah, really, like I love those like juicy hands. And then you realize how much permission your hands get to, how much they can express, right? They just seem like they're this, but they could be so much more. Yeah, I love that. Good. I'm glad you enjoyed that. Yes, you know, me too. I woke up and I was like, I can barely move today. Someone's in the chat said, I feel very tense. And oh, that's how I felt this morning. I was like, so it's really nice, right? And especially right here, I think all of us are holding this deep tension in the center of our chest, and the ability to just sort of let that go. It's amazing what it can do for our whole thing. And if you're more of a singer, what it can do for your vocal quality too. If your body is nice and relaxed, this is a great way that is kind of a good warm up in auditions. You look crazy, but people just leave you alone, which is great, right? You don't want to talk too much before an audition anyways. Okay, so for our next portion of class, we're going to allow ourselves to get creative. So what we're going to do is we're going to build a piece of choreography, and you're going to be really the choreographer. I'm going to give you guidelines or kind of places to move within. And don't worry, we're not doing batmas or anything like that. So don't immediately think we're switching gears. We're not. We're staying in this very pedestrian open place. But I'm just going to give you some guidelines, and then we're going to kind of create the story around it. Kind of have a discussion of how someone might choreograph something like a party scene, right? This is kind of the experience of that. So let us start. So I'm going to give you ideas, and you can take your time feeling out what those ideas mean to you. So first thing is we're just going to be standing, and what we talked about, I think I see a lot with especially young students when they go in to sing. There's a difference between this like stillness. So maybe like take a second to find like a real sense of deadness, like gravity stillness, right? That gravity is taking over your body and you're still. And then the difference, if you were kind of just floating molecularly, right? You don't have to be like this before an audition, but there's an availability, a openness that's not, right? But it's human because you're just open and ready. Yeah, so let's try those three ideas just to really feel the difference. You walk into the room and you're feeling like very gravity driven. So there's like, you can feel everything shut off, right? And then you're all the way, like your teachers told you to be like second row balcony, arms back, there's a boat, there's a train, right? Which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. It's definitely a vibe, but that feels very on top of whatever. And then I want you to come from a molecular place where you feel really alive, even in the back of your body, in the shoulder blades. Can you back acting, right? Back acting. Can you really feel that back acting, that everything is rushing through you at this really beautiful pace? Good. So in that stillness, I call it active stillness. So finding that sense of active stillness where you feel available or ready for any emotion or any movement, yeah? This is a good place to always start, especially in shows or in performances, this active stillness. Good, and then in this active stillness, your next moment is to hear something sharply. And it can be either way, it can be any direction. You can hear it from above, you can hear it from below, but the idea is to create a dynamic with an emotion. So hear it sharply. So whatever it is, I'm gonna change it up every time. You can too, until you settle on something that feels organic. We'll just try it a couple of times. So maybe I'll snap. We hear something sharply. Good, and we hear something sharply. And we hear something sharply. Good, so you're gonna have three of those. So you'll hear something sharply. And then maybe you hear it from a different angle. Really try to challenge your mind. And then you're gonna hear it from a third angle. Good, and on that third angle, up, you're gonna feel something skirt around your feet. So that can be whatever, but it can feel maybe playful. Let's say sharp, sharp, sharp. And then when you're looking away, something playful catches you. Whew, and you feel it, like maybe tickle your feet. So that can be whatever. You can even lift a leg. Whatever feels good. I want you to trust what your body does within the emotion. And then you're choreographing. That's the whole thing, yeah? So three things sharply. And then you find a little, maybe like cute little ferret under your feet or a little otter. Yeah? And if you want to make noises, be my guest. Yeah, I can't hear you. So I'll just sound like a crazy person alone. So you feel a little something tickle you. Good. And let's say that tickle, that little tickle happens one time, and then you go back to the place you just were, but this time smoothly. So meaning your gaze goes back to the place it was smoothly. And then I want you to feel like maybe that little ferret took you to this beautiful world and you're seeing that for the first time. So you're going to come around yourself. You're going to walk around yourself in a circle. And I want you to feel like the breeze and allow breath and how you walk. Is the soil soft? Is it hard? Is it delicate or is it sturdy, right? These are all things we can think about. They can all inform how we move. So we walk around. So whatever it is for you, that can be whatever, right? And notice, I'm not turning it into like this, right? Which has its place, but that's the expression, right? Is that, but we're just feeling it from a human place. So we see everything. I really want you to take it in. You see all of it. I'm gonna think that the floor is very delicate, and I'm gonna think that the breeze and the trees are expansive and green and pink and orange. And then you're gonna come back to center. Good. Let's try that from the top. I'll say sharp, sharp, sharp. I'll give you all the cues. If you wanna live in something a little longer, live in it longer. We're just building. So here we go. So we're here, we're in our active stillness. Your hands can be wherever. If you feel like you wanna create a shape with your arms, be my guest, it doesn't matter. Whatever feels good to you, the story that you're creating here. Good, so then three things sharp. We hear sharp, sharp, sharp. And then here's a little otter. And then smooth. Good, and then, oh my gosh, I didn't even notice. I was so trapped in my own world. Look at all of this. Really care if your feet are moving on this surface. Good, and then back to center. Good, let's add on. So after we CCC and we take a little walk and we allow ourselves to feel the breeze, after we get back to the front or whatever your front is after our circle, some body part is going to buckle. So you get to pick. You can do knees, which is like really obvious, right? Which is just fine. Maybe it's your solar plexus, your stomach, like you get punched. Maybe it's your shoulder, like it just needs to sort of buckle. So that wasn't really a buckle, but like maybe that would be a buckle. So something, imagine, if you wanna imagine a punch, you can imagine a punch or a kick, but something buckles. Even if it's your head, it can buckle, right? Whatever feels good to you. So something buckles, and from that buckle, you start to feel really, really heavy. So your hands can maybe go down to your knees, and you kind of feel like the Atlas Man, where there's like a big weight on the back of your body. And you're gonna try to start to push that weight up. Good, and then there's a difference here. Here we're gonna fall into the habit of like, right? That's gonna be like maybe where we wanna go. And I want you to go from a really intrinsic emotional place. Can you imagine what that sort of atlas is? What that big world means to you? I mean, right now it could be anything, right? So even if it's as small as your coffee was cold when you woke up this morning, you made it and for some reason the water didn't boil and it was freezing cold. And that can be just as heavy, right, as a global pandemic. So depends on the day, right? So I want you to feel like you're trying to push that off and really use your hands against your thighs, really use that actual weight. So that real touch, that real sense of touch as you climb your way all the way back up your body till you can let your shoulders just go down. And I really want to see that idea that maybe there were like strings here and it just rolled off and you can just go and let it all go. Good. So that second part, as we came around the corner, we let our feet, our knees, our elbow, our wrist, anything buckle. And then suddenly someone puts this big heavy weight on your back and you're going to allow yourself to push it off. And if you want to close your eyes in this activity, you can absolutely. If you want to challenge yourself to keep your eyes open, it can really sometimes inform the experience differently. All the way up, letting your shoulders come to your ears, and then at the last minute, it rolls off, and you let it fall down your back. Good, one last little concept here. We're gonna reach our arm out in any direction, and you're gonna do it like somebody grabbed it. Yeah, so somebody kind of grabs your arm that you don't even know is there, yeah? And that can go any direction. It can be either arm, but it's like, and you're kind of shocked by that experience. And then you realize it's the person you love most in the world. And so you're going to start to, wherever that is, it can be down low, it can be a child, it can be someone who's gone up maybe to the ethereal unknown place, anywhere, yeah? And you see them and they're coming towards you, so you're going to turn your chest, and right here, all of that weight, all of that everything is going to soften off of your body. You're going to become really supple, really available again to being loved. Hands will reach out together, and then you're going to take that idea, and I really want you to feel what their face would be like. So your hands here, we're going to play with the idea of tension, right? You could drag someone or you could softly guide them. And that's all in the dexterity or the emotion that's in your hands, right? So you're going to maybe guide them all the way until suddenly they disappear in your hands. Maybe find your own face if you're comfortable touching your face. I know some people aren't, my best friend's so terrified of acne, she doesn't. So you can always just go to your chest if that's more comfortable for you. But if you want to go to your face, and then here's something I see a lot. Sometimes we don't realize how much we can really touch our face. So I'll get close. So there's sometimes this, right? And that's kind of distant. And then there's the middle. And then there's actually like allowing the weight of your hands to touch your face. And that's going to create maybe something not so pretty down here, but that's okay. Just see what it's like to really feel the weight of your hands. And the last thing you're going to do is with the weight of your hands on your face, really try to put weight. You're going to shift 4 times, 2, 3, 4, and then you're going to let your hands fall with that gravity idea, and that'll just kind of be the end, yeah? So it's just a little story, and who knows what it means, right? It doesn't have to mean what I'm saying. It can mean whatever you want. It can literally about, it can be about anything, but there's lots of emotions, lots of layers, and a lot of things to play with within it, right? So let's go for it one time without music. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put on different songs and see how we sort of adapt to different music with it, yeah? So here we go. So you have 3 sharp looks to start. It goes sharp, sharp, sharp. Good, and then you feel the little otter under your feet. And then you look back to where you were looking. And then, oh my gosh, where am I? And you really feel that, whatever that is. I'm not going to give you too much info, right? I'm going to let you discover what that is for you. Good. And then when you finally get back to center, something's going to buckle your knees or buckle your elbow or buckle your chin. And your hands are going to fall to your knees and you're going to push your way up. Really feel the weight. Doesn't matter how long this takes. You do not have to rush it. You can let it live for as long as you need for it to live, pushing your way up. And your shoulders come with you. And then they fall down your back. Good. Really, really nice. And then from there, let me do my notes. Even I forget sometimes, right? So from there, something's going to pick up your arm and you're going to be so surprised, right? Something you didn't know. And then you'll see who it is. And I want you to see who it is first and then let your body experience the emotion after, right? So see who it is and then let yourself, whatever that brings to you, allow it to come up and really feel it. And then you're reaching and you're grabbing their head. Down here, it doesn't matter. Grabbing their head, bringing them towards you. All the way, like you're gonna get to finally kiss them and then they leave. And maybe this is, you thought the whole thing was a dream or maybe it's devastation. Whatever it is, you're gonna shift here for 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you'll let the arms drop. And then you have to become just available again. So in this last moment, let's allow ourselves to become available, to lift, to look, like we could start the whole thing over again. Yeah, so we refined that sense of availability and we let the story kind of live where it was in the past. Cool, I think we're good enough to, we feel good? Yeah, I think we're cool enough to just explore it now with some music. Nothing is wrong. There is no wrong move, there's no wrong thing. If you do something completely different because you forget the order, I really don't care. I can't see most of you anyways, so it really doesn't matter. So yeah, so just experience what you're experiencing this morning. And if something takes you or surprises you, go with it. Just follow that desire, yeah? So let's go with a few songs here. Here, this one was up. This one might be interesting to play with.
It's been a long dark night.
This one's gonna be like, it's really gonna tell you a little bit what to do, right?
I've been waiting for the morning.
Good.
It's been,
so you can just step back in your space and find that active stillness.
But I can see.
And you can start whenever you want. If you want to follow me, I can follow, and then you can decide what you, I'll say it out loud, and then you can sort of find your own kind of pacing as we move forward.
Sunshine.
And sharp, sharp,
cause I ain't seen it in so long.
And then you see the world.
Everything's gonna work out just fine. Everything's gonna be alright.
And buckle.
It's been all wrong.
And then you feel the weight of the world.
I can see the light of a clear morning.
So much your ears come up, you can't even handle it.
I can see the light of a brand new day.
Someone grabs your hand.
I can see. It's gonna be okay.
And they disappear within you.
It's been a long, long time.
Two.
Since I've known the taste of freedom.
Four. Let your hands drop.
And most clean.
And then refine that activeness, that ability to keep moving on.
That held me bound, well, I don't need.
That one really gave us sort of a lot of information, right? That beautiful song, it kind of gave us an idea, right? It gave us a really clear conception. So let's work with another song that's not as clear. And I think sometimes lyrics, right, or human voice can help with that clarity. But sometimes when it's just music, it's a little harder to find. So we get really attached, I think, to counts in dance, right? Or when we're in theater, we get attached to like, what count is that on? What count is that on? But 90% of the time, if a choreographer is choreographing, they're feeling the phrase or the emotion of the music. So I want you to really think of the phrasing of the music and the emotional quality of the music, and don't get locked up in sort of what count or what's right. Really just feel the music for all of its phrasings, yeah? All right, let me pick something that would really work well with that. I really like, this one's really good. Already, right? There's a little bit different energy behind it. Here we go. Sharp, sharp, sharp. Was juicy. That one gave us all the phrasings, right? Did you see how the music sort of told you when to change or when to move, right? There's all of this sort of, you can imagine the pianist, right? He feels the swells, and we can feel that and occupy that as movers as well. And that's dancing. That's the whole thing, right? Following the phrasing of music. We get really obsessed with like, yes, queen, right? And then that's fine, right? But that doesn't mean anything if there's not emotion behind it. So a développé, right? If we're just going to take a second to talk about when you go to the next level of this, right? A développé has a whole experience and an expression and a lift and a breath, right? It's the same as this. You're just adding a freaking leg to it. It doesn't matter, right? The leg is secondary. The emotion is primary. So just remember that when you're dancing and you're getting confused and you're maybe feeling like, just remember, it's all just feeling what life is about. That's what dance is, right? We didn't start dance in fifth position. We started dance like, you know, back in the like days when it was just so that we could get something else or we could greet the gods or, you know, so really think about the root of why we dance. Let's do one more and then I'll take some questions, a little discussion at the end if we want. Oh, one more. Let's do this one. Ooh, okay, two more. I'm gonna do two more real quick. Let's do this one.
It's very clear. Our love is here to stay.
Okay, we've got lyrics again.
Not for a year.
Find what the vibe is for you.
Forever and a day.
Here we go.
The radio.
Start.
Telephone.
Fire.
And the movies that we know, they're all just passing fast.
And it's okay to take on the energy of the song.
Oh,
and buckle.
My dear, our love is here to stay.
Maybe the heaviness is a little bit happier. It's a little bit more like pleasure.
Together,
working for a relationship.
Yeah, going along.
And let it go.
In time, the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble there. They're only made of clay.
Oh,
is here to stay.
Wait on the hand and sway. Stuff, right? Okay, let's do one more dramatic one because I love a good drama on a Wednesday at 12, yeah? So let's do one more really dramatic one just so we can let all of our emotions out, really dive into that human experience. And then from there, we will figure it out. Let's see, what's a really good dramatic one? Okay, I'm gonna do, no. Okay. This has lyrics, but this is my favorite song right now to imagine myself in like somewhere, and it's from a musical. So let's go with it. It's Flowers from Hadestown. So we're going to just dive into the song because it's so beautiful and so emotional. Still think about all of the phrasing ideas that we talked about. Don't just get lost in the lyrics. Good. Get yourself ready, fix all your clothes. I always do that, I always pick at myself. Don't do that, you don't have to do that. Good. Get yourself active and ready. Look.
What I wanted was to fall asleep. Close my eyes and disappear. Like a paddle on a stream, a feather on the air. Trembled when he laid me out. You won't feel a thing, he said, when you go down. nothing gonna wake you now. Dreams are sweet until they're not.
Cool. Let us, if Gigi's okay with it, just have a minute or so of conversation. If you want to put your video on and just wave, or if you're naked, good, I'm proud of you. Stay naked, but keep your video off. Or just let me know in the chat how you felt, or share, whatever you want. No pressure, but I think the last thing I'll leave you with in terms of this concept is, I think we talk a lot about authenticity. People are always demanding or expecting you to be authentic. And I always felt like, what the does that mean? Like, and so many people would tell me like, oh, you're really inauthentic. Like, you really put it on. And it kind of messed with my brain. I wrote my senior thesis at Chapman about authenticity in dancers. Like, I really, and that was not the good subject because it's so hard to encapsulate. But what I've learned over the years is that what feels right to you is normally what's authentic. And the more that you do exercises like this, and the more that you take time to really listen to music and think about how you hear it and how you experience it, you're gonna continue to find your sense of artistic creativity and your artistry, really, especially when it comes to movement. So you'll no longer be an ensemble person like getting a drink for no reason. You'll start to realize how much this can transfer into that, and you can authentically have a drink. It sounds crazy, right? But like, you know the difference when someone's like, and now I take a shot and then I put it down. Like, and you can see when someone's like really taking a shot, right? If you've never taken a shot before, don't go try it right now. It's too early. But I think, know that, at least for me, that comment of authenticity, don't worry about what your face is doing. Don't worry about if you're the right shape or size or color, anything like that. But if it feels real to you and it comes from your heart and your gut, then it's authentic. And whatever that expression is, just know that that's right for right now. Don't judge who you are based on a moment, yeah, or someone's comment about you. Just allow yourself to continue to dive into your artistry and find who you are as an artist. And I think this is a great way to privately do that, especially during this time. So if you want to find me on Instagram, I'll put my name here. And you want to continue this conversation with me, I'm such a nerd. Leslie knows I can talk about dance for hours and hours and hours. I wrote my name wrong. On hours and hours and hours on end. So if you want to talk about dance or life, let me know. And I am so grateful that you guys came and explored moving in a way that may have been uncomfortable, but I hope you felt something good from it.
We're grateful. We're grateful to you. You're just so amazing. Just such a beautiful expression for not just dance, but in life, just to take in and appreciate all these things around us. So again, Natalie, you're amazing. I would reach out to Natalie if you have any questions, and I know that she will be teaching for us again.